Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through congestion control in virtual circuits, guys. So remember one thing, guys. Whenever we are talking about virtual circuits, it is nothing but connection oriented. Remember that. So even I used to confuse whenever they are saying virtual. So it doesn't exist. So virtual means what, guys? It doesn't exist. So I thought it is wireless. So I used to confuse a lot in this topic, guys. So I am requesting you to remember that virtual is connection oriented. Because in many topics, we will be saying that virtual circuit. Okay? So always remember that it is connected. Okay. So to do congestion control, we will be following two principles. Okay? There are two alternative methods, you can say. So one is admission control. So this technique is used to keep the congestion which has already begun. So if the congestion is already existing, to control it, we'll be using this mechanism. So it states that once congestion is detected, do not set up any more virtual connections until the congestion is clear. Simple and easy to carry out. So assume that there is a particular thing, guys. So in this way. Okay. So assume it in this way. And you are trying to transfer the data from here to here. But this path is congested and this path is congested. So the only possibility for you will be in this way, right? So you stop adding these more nodes or more things until this congestion is whole clear. That is nothing but this transfer of data is whole done. Until it is completely done, do not update it, because if you update it, there will be multiple paths. Again, there is a high chance that everyone will start sending the data and there will be a huge issue, right? So that is the reason why admission of the control is done once it has occurred. One of the alternative approach is nothing but an alternative approach is to admission control is to allow the virtual circuit to set up even when the congestion is taken place. So here I told, if congestion is there, do not add any paths, right? So but alternate approach says that you can add paths but not in the congestion flow. You should add them outside the congestion flow, but carefully route all the virtual circuits around the problem area. That is nothing but not through it, around it. If you take this example, so here we are having two positions of congestion, guys. So if you observe here, is there any other path, guys? If you observe carefully from A to B, there is one more path. You can observe it here. Oh, sorry, not that, this path. Sorry, that's my bad. Okay, in this way. So this was written here. Okay, so here there is congestion, but we are able to reach to our destination through some other path. So you need to search for these kind of paths, guys. Okay, so I hope everyone got some basic idea, because I even did not find that much theory about these topics, guys. So I'm just introducing you and I'm giving you a small examples for that. Okay, so I hope everyone got some basic idea. So in the next lecture, we'll be going through congestion control in datagram subnets. Thank you. Thanks for watching.